Well, it's so nice to speak to you about your song, which I have literally listened to like 7 times this morning, because I think it's like maybe the best pop song I've ever heard.
Oh, thank you so much.
But when I was laughing, you know, you're just saying like, oh, I can just hear my mum in the back of my mind. Saying I want you to ruin my life is something that I would say to my mum about someone, and she'd be like, what do you mean?
What do you mean?
Like, what do you mean? Yeah. I feel like it's a really funny thing that we say and we just accept that it's normal to say. Why ruin your life? Why that message?
Because I feel like, you know, I was debating with myself, that I always do, whether it's good for me as an artist, especially a woman, to talk about a relationship that was not great, but you want back.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? And it's like, I don't want to promote that. But at the same time, I also just want to speak my truth. In a way, if you can say that, I'm quoting, air quoting, because I've been feeling that way. I've been in a really bad relationship that's not good for me and it's not good for the other person. And we're just really bad for each other. But then you end up breaking up and you're like, I want nothing more than to get back with this person, even though I know it's bad for me. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And I know that it's going to ruin my life in the sense of it will break my heart and I won't be able to sleep for like 3 months and I won't be able to do, you know, enjoy stuff that I think is fun because I will just be ruined by this person. But I still want it.
Yeah.
You know, it's quite relatable, I think. At least the people I have in my life has been there at some point. So, I'm always debating a bit, but then I think it's just a beautiful and relatable song. And it doesn't necessarily have to be about a relationship. Like, it could be about a friendship that you know wasn't good for you. Like, you could be young and dumb and you do all this dumb stuff together and you know, like, this is basically ruining me. Whether it is like you drop out of school or you, I don't know what it could be, but that's just what I felt. And I think it's just a really powerful pop song at the end of the day.
It's also like, it is like what you said, everyone has that. And even if you haven't had it, you've had like your friends be like, I know that I shouldn't be with them, but I want to. And you're like, oh, it's gonna ruin you. I can't watch this happen.
Exactly.
So everyone everyone knows.
I think so.
Do you have like, what's your tactic when you are like, because everyone has that thing of like, I'm not gonna call them, I'm not gonna call them. Do you have a way of like making sure that you don't slip back into
I wish. I need it. I mean, not right now. I'm in a very happy, healthy relationship at the moment. But when you've been in those situations, it's just like, it's just one drink and then it's all gone.
Yeah.
All the rules you have for yourself. But I think time really does its thing.
Yeah.
It really does. And, you know, I think it's just, you got to block and delete. Someone said that, imagining that you killed the person. And you have to delete all the evidence of that you ever knew that person if the police is going to go through your phone, which is quite smart because, you know, you just got to like, don't save the message, like don't save the pictures. Like, don't. Why do you need that?
Yeah.
What do you need that for? I think it's just really hard to move on from that. But I wish I had some tips. I would just say that time does its thing.
You will be good
and you will meet someone who is worthy of you.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Do you find it easier to write like breakup songs when you are in a happy relationship and you're like, oh, this isn't actually that painful anymore?
Right. I do think in general, it's easier to write about just like a specific thing that might have happened or a specific feeling. And it's really hard to write about being happy.
Yeah.
So anything that's like not being happy, I think, because it can just be cheesy so easy.
Yeah.
But I do have some songs, like pure love songs, on this upcoming record. And I would just say love in general. I mean, whether it is like breakup or, you know, oh, I really want this person. I feel like most of my songs actually has some sort of a, like almost a sexual undertone.
Yeah.
Do you know what I mean?
Yeah,
where
yeah.
It's like, I would like definitely 100%, or you know, some of my songs that's like, oh, okay, that's quite easy to write about. But just love in general, I feel like it's quite relatable for most people.
I think everyone feels it in some way, like you said, even if it's not with a boyfriend or a girlfriend, or like, Even if it's with your cat.
Exactly.
Like, everyone feels love.
Yeah. Absolutely.